why it is required, and through a flow chart, I have given you the idea of how the reflex are. But today, by using a simple diagram, it is time to give you the what exactly happens during the reflex action. Now, as I told you that the thermal coordination of the reflex action is carried out by the part of the central nervous system, that is our spinal cord. Now, our spinal cord at the vertebral column is having total 33 vertebrae, that is the part of the bones. And out of that 33, the last one, that doesn't have any outlet of the neurons, and the top one is also not having the outlet of the neurons. Now, based on the 31, so just I have found just one, and out of that, the two neurons, one is called sensory neuron, other one is called the motor neuron, that arise through a relay neuron. Relay, you must be knowing that is the passing of the information from one to another, like you have seen into the relay race, that baton is just passed on to the next player who takes it and runs away. The same way, here the messages are being taken and being carried out. Now, the reflex action is necessary in order to protect our body parts from the various physical hazards like hot water, like the spines, wherever you touch. Naturally, if your hand remains inside the hot water, it will burn out. Because what happens in the heat, the message that goes from your skin to the brain, it will take a lot of time. And naturally, for the purpose of removal of the organ from the brain, just to remove it, this will take time, and in this period, your whole skin will get burned out. So that's why this is needed to be removed immediately as soon as that hotness of the water is felt. So for that purpose only, the spinal cord itself that controls and coordinates those instant automatic physical actions whenever there is required. Now what happens? The sensory nerve, they are associated with the skin, which is having the receptors that I have told you earlier. From the receptor side, the message or the impulse that is being picked up and passed to the sensory neuron through the spinal cord, where this is passed on to the motor neuron through the relay neuron. And the motor neuron that acts on the muscles, and by the constriction of the muscles, just your hands are being removed from the hot water. So, this way, it forms an arc. That's why in the previous lesson or the previous class, I have told you draw the things in a flow chart manner. So now this is the diagrammatic representation of the reflex action, which is being controlled and operated by the brain. Sorry, the spinal cord. Now what happens? Question arises whether this action is being carried out after that, whether this message pass on to the brain or not. Of course, this message that goes on to the brain also where the damage occurs that is being assessed, because this is the instant action that is taking place at removal. But when your hand goes into the hot water, majorly certain damage will have taken place. So you will not immediately, but after some time you start feeling pain. So this feeling of the pain, that is being that message that comes from the brain. So certainly these messages, although this action is taking place right over here instantly, but that passed to the brain as well. And then after assessing the damages, just you are being directed through a setup of pain so that you can take care of the damages. Now as I told you, there are, apart from the 33 vertebra, there are 31 remaining. And therefore, there are 31 pairs of these nerves are there, and these are called the peripheral nerves, as I explained in the first part. So these are the peripheral nerves. But what about our this reflex action onto the facial region? Now the facial region, that is not connected to the these neurons on the spinal cord, but those neurons go into the brain itself, directly to the brain, and then it is directly assessed. Like if suddenly you rush to the bright light, what happens? Your eyelid gets closed and gradually the pupil gets smaller, so that there is no damage to the retina, still of the absence of the retina. So how these reflexes occur? This reflex is normally propagated by the brain through the facial nerves. So these peripheral nerves are having a full life. One is associated with the spinal cord, that is the 31 pairs. Thereafter 12 pairs are associated with the brain, and that is the facial nerves, which are the single nerves. Remember, facial nerves are the single nerves which carry out both the function. There is no relay system over there. That is directly taken care of by the both the axons by those facial nerves. So just in order to summarize the reflex action, where I have dealt with the types of the nerves or the nervous system, we can call it the peripheral nervous system, that is associated with the peripheral part of the body, and that is the spinal cord that controls and coordinates the reflex action, which is very much required to protect your body from the severe damage. Now, the next part of the central nervous system, and I told you that central nervous system that is having the two part, that is spinal cord and the brain. Now we have discussed about the spinal cord and its function. So the remaining part is the brain of the central nervous system. Now what is brain and what is there inside the brain? Remember, brain is the most delicate organ of our body, which is made up of the bunches of millions of neurons, and these neurons are myelinated. So the color of the whole brain, if you observe, that is the gray in color. We can call it the whole brain, that is the gray matter also. And the spinal cord, the nerves are unmyelinated, so they are white in color. Now brain, as I told you, that is the most important part of our body, that which controls and coordinates all the functions of our body. naturally, this requires the highest protection and highest supply of the blood as well. Human brain cells, whatever the neurons are there, they must be supplied with the adequate quantity of blood over there. And in this, you must have heard about people are becoming brain dead. So, how the people become brain dead? Because the function of the brain stops over there and the total control of the body that is being lost apart from the certain involuntary organs which are working with the autonomous nervous system like our heart. That is working with the autonomous nervous system. So, people with the dead brain may be surviving because the vital functions will still continue to be there. But the total control of the body, like various functions, speaking, observing, feeling, those are being lost over there. So, such people are called, that is, having the dead brain. And persons are said to be in the coma and something like that, that occurs due to the accidents of the brain hemorrhage and all. So, regarding brain hemorrhage, I will talk to you later. So, here what I need to say that brain is the very, very important. And every important part of our body, they have been having given a lot of protection from the physical shocks or the injuries. Same way, brain is located inside a bony cavity that is called cranial cavity. Location of brain, that is in the cranial cavity like this one. This is the cavity where the entire brain is located. Now, this cranial cavity is further protected by the overlapping bony structure. And these bones, the upper one, they are divided into the parts and they are associated with like this system. And the two parts of the brain are associated with this system. This is because after the birth of a child, the brain also develops in the age of 11 or 12. And during that time, it develops. Naturally, these bones must have the adequate space to accommodate that. So, in order to accommodate that, this set of brains and bones are there. And in the newly born child, it should be touched in there, the middle part of the top of the head. You will find this is having the little hollow part. This hollow part is just packed with these bones. Gradually, when the brain is finally or not fully developed. Now, not only this one, this bony structure protects the brain, but also there is required membrane, and these three types of membranes are there in different organisms. The number of membranes may be varying, like in fishes there is only one membrane, but in human beings you will find that the three meninges are there, and in between these meninges here that is filled with the fluid, and this fluid, this is called cerebrospinal fluid, that is CSF. The short we can call it CSF, cerebrospinal fluid. Like in the same manner in our heart also, the heart is also having covered with a membrane, and in between the membrane and the heart muscle there is a fluid that is called pericardial fluid. Similarly in the lungs also, in the lung cells over it there is a membrane, in between the membrane there is pleural fluid. So what is the function of this fluid between the organ and the membrane? Here also the physics works, that you must have heard about the pressure applied into a liquid. If a pressure is applied at any point of a liquid, it can be distributed into a heavy part. So naturally, if any physical shock that occurs over here onto the membrane, and if it will not be protected, it will directly hit the organ and the damage will occur. But when this fluid is there in between, the pressure coming over here that gets excreted into the entire fluid, and thereby the impact of pressure that is reduced tremendously, and thereby our organ remain protected. So whatever organ may be, delicate or important organs are there, there is a fluid in between the membrane and the main organ, so that any physical shock that is being protected. So this is the about the location and the positioning of the brain. And one more thing I would like to add over here, you must have heard about the some sort of disease in the children especially, that is called meningitis. Now meningitis, itis, whenever this is being added to a organ or the part, it means the inflammation. So inflammation into the meninges, that is the membrane over the brain, because of certain infection, that is called meningitis. And this meningitis that causes severe fever and maybe causing to damage the brain as well. So this is one information, additional information I have given you right now. So with this, today I am ending my class. In the next part, I will talk about the structure and the various parts of the brain, and thereafter their associated functions as well. So thank you for today.